In this session, we will discuss array object in JavaScript. So first of all, we are trying to understand when we should go for array concept. So suppose we want to store details of first employee. Suppose we want to store details of employee. To storing one employee details, we have required one variable. Suppose we have one variable emp1, which contains the employee ID 101. So emp1 contain what contain, which type value contain, integer type contain value contain. This variable is a primitive type variable. Primitive type variable means which can hold only one value at a time. Remember this point, primitive type variables is allowed to hold one value at a time. In primitive type variable, we can't store multiple value. Suppose if you want to store another employee ID, then we have required another employee 2 variable which contains another employee ID. Suppose tomorrow we want to store 500 employees ID. To store 500 employees ID, you will have to create 500 variable. It is not a good practice to store in multiple value. We will have required to create multiple value. That are problem we are facing, because remembering multiple variable name, it is not good practice. To resolve such type problems, then we introduce one concept, that is a array. So array is a variable under we can store multiple value. So using array concept, we can store multiple value under a single variable. So primitive types, actually primitive type variable is allowed to storing one value at a time. At a time, one variable can hold one value. To store multiple value, you will have to create multiple variable. But using array concept, we can store multiple value under a single variable. So array is a variable which can hold multiple value. So we can say array is a collection type variable. Container type variables, this means which can contain another type object. So now read this point. Array is an object that can store a collection of items. Array is a special type variable which can store multiples value. So in other languages, just like a C and Java, we learn array. So array in Java C language, array is also used to holding multiple value, but all values should be similar type. But in JavaScript array can store multiple element of different data types also. In JavaScript array, is not required to store value of same data type in array. So remember this point, keep in your mind, JavaScript array can hold multiple element of different data type. Also, in JavaScript array is not required to store value of same data type in array. So array is a variable which can hold multiple value and multiple type also. So when we should go for array concept? So whenever you want to store multiple value or different type or similar type, then we should go for array concept. So remember this point, when we should go for array. So whenever we want to store multiple value of same type or different type, then we should go for array concept. So how we can create array in JavaScript? There are different ways to creating array in JavaScript. You can create array in JavaScript directly by using square bracket. Using square bracket, you can create array in JavaScript directly. Suppose here we create one array where arr equal to square bracket. If you are not placing element within a square bracket, it means it just create one empty array. If you want to create one array with some element, so how you can create? where AR are equal to square bracket. Within a square bracket, we can place a value and where each value should be separated by comma. So suppose we want to store another value. Now we want to store another value. Want to store another value. So here we create one array which contains 5 elements. So now comes in program. So how we can create array in JavaScript? Watch here. For this, we have created one file array1.html. Now within a body section, we create a script tag. So here we create one array where my array one equal to square bracket. So now we are print the array document dot write my underscore array one. So array having one property, that is a length property, which returns the number of element that are present in the array. So if you want to know how many element array contains, you can know by using length property. So here we are calling the length property on my underscore array one variable. So my underscore array one dot length. Now we create another array where my underscore array two. So this array contains 3 elements. Now print this variable document dot write my array two plus within double quote we are placing the br tag. Now document dot write. What is the length of array? Length equal to plus my underscore array two dot length. Plus br tag. So here we are also mention the message. Length equal to plus and plus br tag. Plus br tag. Br tag is used for breaking the line. So now save this program. First of all, run this applications. So watch here. Length of first array 0, second array element 10, 20, 30, and second array length is 3. So we can create an array in JavaScript by using square bracket directly. Within a square bracket, we can place the element in where each item separated by another item by comma. So I hope you will understand. Now we see another way to create array object in JavaScript. So you can initialize an array with array constructor by using new keyword. So you can create array in JavaScript also by using array constructor. So how we can create new array? So you can create an array in this way also. If you create array by using array constructor, it will create one empty array. But you can create in this way also new array, just pass the value. Suppose we are passing 5, it means here we are create one array which having the 5 element. You can create array also new array and pass the value 10 comma 20 comma 30 comma 40. It means here we create one array which contains 4 element, where first element is 10, second element 20, and third element is 30, and fourth element is 40. So remember this point. In this way we can create also array object in JavaScript. So first of all, here declare an array. First we are declare an array using the array constructor and then populating the value in array. So how we can populate the array value in array? Actually, we already know every value in array which are present that have index position. Each element which are present in array have one index position. Index position start from 0 and length minus 1. So first element index position in array 0, second element index position is a 1. So last element position is a length minus 1. So here we create one array. Watch here, comes in program. So for this we create one file and give this file name is array2.html. So now we create HTML. Within the HTML we create the head section. Now create the body section within a body section. Now create the body section within a body section. Create the script tag. Now within a script tag, we are writing the JavaScript code. So here we create one array where string array. So here we create array by using array constructor. So just use new array constructor. So here we are create array constructor without parameter. If you create array by using array constructor without passing any parameter, then it will create simply one empty array. So here just we are creating one empty array. First of all, we are defining an array. Now we are populating the element in this array. So how we can populate? Watch here. We can populate element in array by using index positions. So string array. So first element position 0. In 0 position we want to populate. Suppose 1. Now string array 1 position we want to populate 2. And now string array. Now third element we want to populate 3. So here we create one array. First up are we are declaring the array and then we are populating the value into array. Now we are printing the array document dot write. Element of an array equal plus string array. Now we are printing the length of an array document dot write. Length of an array string array dot length property. So now save this program. Now we run this application. So watch here. Element of array 1, 2, 3. And length of an array is 3. So we want to print next line. So here we have required to br tag. Now save this program and run this application again. So now we have got the element of an array 1, 2, 3 and length of an array is 3. Now we see another way to create an array in JavaScript. So suppose we want to create an array with 3 elements. So how we can create? So now comes in program. Here we are create one file array3.html. Now within a script tag, we are creating the array. So suppose we want to create one array with name numeric array, which contain numeric value. But this array having the length 3. So how we can create by using array constructor with 3 element? So equal new. Here we create array constructor and passing that 3 value. If you pass one value, it means we are creating one array which can have 3 element. So here we are passing one value in array constructor that indicates the length of an array. So now after creating array, now we are populating the value in array. So how we can populate value in array? By using index position. So numeric array. In the first value, we want to populate 10. Now another value, numeric array 1 equal to 20. Now numeric array followed by square bracket 2 equal to 30. Now we are printing the array document dot write element of an array equal plus numeric array. So numeric array is a variable which contains 3 elements. So now print the length of an array document dot write length of length of an array plus numeric array dot length property. So length property returns the length of an array. So here we are using the br tag. Now save this program. Now run this application. So watch here, we got it, the output element of array 10, 20, 30 and length of an array 3. Now we see another way to create an array. Suppose we want to create one array. At the time of the creation of array, that time we want to initialize element of an array. So here we learn declaring and populating the array at the same type using array constructor. So now comes in program. For this we create one file array4.html in the script tag. So here we take one variable mixed element equal to new array. So here we are passing 10 comma and within single quote we are passing hello and 1.5 comma true. It means here we create one array which contains four elements. In the first element value is 10, second element value is hello, third element value is 1.45 and fourth element value is true. It means array can have different type value also. So in JavaScript array, no need to storing only similar type value. JavaScript array can have similar type and different type value also. So now we are printing the array. So document dot write element of an array equal plus mixed element plus br tag we are using. Document dot write length of an array plus mixed element dot length. Now save this program. Now run this application. So watch here, now we have gotten the output. So in this way we can create array in JavaScript. So how we can create array in JavaScript? You can create array in JavaScript directly using array literals, using square bracket, or you can create array in JavaScript using array constructor. So remember this note point also, if only one number is passed to the array constructor. Suppose here we create one 3 array constructor. First array constructor we are not passing any value, but in second array constructor we are passing single value and third array constructor we are passing 4 value. So if only one value is passed to the array constructor, then the number is used to set the size of an array. Remember this point. If you pass only single value in array constructor, that value is used to set the size of an array. That value is used to set the size of the array. If you are passing more than one number, then those value will be used as an element to populating the array. So this is not a size of an array, this is an element of array. But if you are passing only one value in array constructor, that is used to set the size of an array. If you are not passing any element to the array constructor, so it means it will create one empty array. So in this way we can create an array. I hope you will understand why we are using the array concept and how we can create array in JavaScript. Thank you.